Corona Reprieve. What a show it's going to be. Three Chords and the Truth. You want to hear Three Chords and the Truth? Some enchanted evening, you will see a stranger. You will see a stranger cross a crowded room. Have we lost all the country fans now?
No.
It's going to be a Corona Reprieve, Mom. And here's a song very similar to, I've never sang this song before.
Never sang this song before.
I had an idea that if I put it like in a kind of a blues sort of thing.
Well, sounds pretty good. What song is it, Daddy?
It's an old Lefty Frizzell song.
Ooh.
That Hank Williams stole. I bet I just got Bo Cephas mad right there. And you don't know it, but I want you to join in on the chorus.
Okay, I'll do my best.
Today I pass you on the street, and my heart fell at your feet. I can't help it if I'm still in love with you. Somebody else stood by your side, and he looked so satisfied. I can't help it if I'm still in love with you.
Cut your clothes.
A picture from the past came slowly stealing as I brushed your arm, walk so close to you. And then suddenly I got the whole time feeling I can't help it if I'm still in love with you.
I can't help it if I'm still in love with you.
Picture from the past came slowly stealing as I brushed your arm and walked so close to you. And then suddenly I got that old time feeling. Oh, I can't help it if I'm still in love with you. No, I can't help it if I'm still in love with you. No, I can't help it if I'm still in love with you. Oh, yeah. Did you get that down, Hank? Keep those people back. The people from the nervous hospital are here. They're going to start throwing the virtual haystacks because this is the Psychedelic Prairie Home Companion. Kick back and chill out to the mellow sounds of the singing DJs. Live from the Griffin Heart Studios in the brawler room of the Griffin Heart Studios, it's the really big old-time radio medicine show starring Molly Griffin and her little dog, doggy-doo.
Little doggy-doo.
And the Reverend Dr. Joe G, too.
Ma, why can't I bear arms? You bear your legs. I want to bear my arms. What the hell? That's not right. You know, just as I was singing that, I just got this feeling where I really...
Yeah, seized?
No, I think it just pushed me into classic country songs.
Let's do it. What are we doing? What is it?
Okay, here we go. Today I started loving you again, and I'm right back where I really always been. Hey, I got over you just long enough to let my heart ache, man.
And then today I started loving you again.
Oh, what a fool I was to think I could get by. With only these few million tears, I cried. Oh, how was I to know the worst was yet to come? And that crying time for me just begun. And then today I started loving you again. Now I'm right back where I really always been. Hey, I got over you just long enough to let my heart ache, man. And in the day I started loving you again. And in the day I started loving you again. And in the day I started loving you again.
So,
I want to pick on the Muslim people, but I had to get something where people put things over their head.
Oh, okay.
So that's how the joke came out. So it's not like I'm not being like racist or nothing like that. But here's how the joke goes.
Okay.
Have you ever seen a Muslim man and woman with both with burqas on?
No.
Because that's what we used to call a two-bagger. You know what a two-bagger is?
No.
Well, that's when you put a bag over your head as well as her head in case hers falls off.
God. It just started bad and got so much worse.
But yeah, I know. It went like straight from racism to sexism, right?
You're just plain mean.
That's just, you know what it is? It's retro. It's from back in the day.
It's not racist, it's retro.
It's not. It's got
it's
nothing
vintage.
To do with racism. Do you know how much I've been picked on in my life?
Tell us about it, Dad.
And by the way, listen to me, because a lot of Muslim people do. Mm. We're friends, man.
Some of your best friends are Muslim.
Totally. The prime source of all motivation has been discovered, and it gives us the first science-based formula for mental health and happiness and, you know, health and fitness.
Mm.
Go to Griffin Hart Patreon and you read all about it.
Mm-hmm.
That's
mm-hmm.
the last I'm going to say. It's got door number one, door number two, door number three. You learn all about it, right? You learn all about your report card and how you get to feel happy.
Mm. Anyway.
Now, here's just a question. Mm-hmm. This is like an interesting question.
Okay.
If we were doing this before speech, would I be grunting and flailing my arms?
Probably with a stick. So it's not that much different, is it?
It's a game of all games within the show of all shows. We have to pick a song now for all the crap I just said. And what would that song be?
Well, I'm feeling like a...
Maybe it should be a song that would be good for the Muslim people just in case I went too far. You know,
we don't have any Muslim songs, Dad.
Of course, behind them things, you know, the beautiful women, you know, from, you know, Middle Eastern, Arabian.
And on top of that, the guys don't wear those things. So your whole joke doesn't make sense.
I know, but they are going to have to ride. I'm going to make them. They wear them, you wear them.
Good plan. I like it.
Would I be grunting and flailing my arms? I am grunting and flailing my arms.
I feel
things
like
haven't changed much.
I feel like Bruce Springsteen song.
Oh. I want, yes, and you think you know the one that you want, but first I want to do another one, which is...
What?
Oh, Springsteen. Yeah. Oh, I was thinking about a very, very similar person.
Uh-huh.
Only his name is Sam Cooke.
Oh, yeah. Well, they're both babes. Let's do it.
Yeah, but you know, I got to get this capo on here because it's my guitar strings are flailing. You're looking around a lot.
Yeah.
Yep.
I don't know where I put
What's that one mall where, you know, I didn't learn much?
Don't know much about history.
We better start. Oh, no. Go ahead.
No, you do it, you do it, you do it, you do it.
All night long, everybody get in the groove and let the good times roll. We got to stay here till we soothe our soul. If it takes all night long, it might be 1 o'clock or it might be 3. I do not care, cause time means nothing to me. I ain't been swinging since I don't know when. Oh, my love is full again. I said, everybody, get in the groove and let the good times roll. We got to stay till we soothe our soul. If it takes all night long.
Okay, I thought you were going to sing something.
No, I was not.
It might be 1 o'clock or it might be 3. I do not care cause time means nothing to me. I ain't been swinging since I don't know when. Oh, my life is full again. I said, everybody, you know why my life is full again?
Why?
Because I went to the Griffin Art Patreon.
Shut up.
And I learned how to do the happy.
Do this part.
In a groove and in a good time, bro. We got to stay here till we soothe our soul. If it takes all night long.
Now do feel so good.
Go ahead.
Feel so good. Now that you're home.
Do you think they know we changed the song?
Come on, baby. Rock me all night long. Pretty mama singing. Get in the groove and let the good time roll. We got to stay here till we soothe our soul. If it takes all night long. If it takes all night long. If it takes all night long. Get in the groove and let that good time roll. Let him roll all night long.
Develop your brain for bigger pictures with more details.
You want to do the ride, Dad?
Go on down to Griffin Art Patreon. Develop your brain. Hey, I've already. I usually only plug it once.
Already done it.
What?
Let's take the ride. Get it done.
You know why? You got to get bigger pictures with more details.
Oh my God.
That's like getting RAM and yeah? Processing.
Why?
RAM and processing
why?
Speed.
Huh.
It's the same. What do you want?
Take the ride.
Okay, we're going to go for a nice little ride now. You're going to go outside there and climb in the back of the old 55 Cadillac limousine. Black.
We're going to take a ride.
Oh, going to take a ride. I pass a honky-tonk.
I pass a honky-tonk.
And pass a county line.
In the county line.
Through the amber waves of grain.
Through those waves of grain.
And pass the dairy cow.
With their big brown eyes.
To the old county line road. The old country road,
gonna take you home.
And all the girlies' toes hanging out of the window. Somebody sees a great big tower, 50,000 watts.
It's Station GHRT. Station GHRT.
Station GHRT.
Station GHRT. It's there for you and me.
Brought to you by Alice's Restaurant.
You can get anything you
anything
want.
Anything you want.
Down at Alice's Restaurant.
Down at
Alice's Restaurant.
Except Alice. We're going to pull in the old Station GHRT there and go to the front desk and see Betty Page.
See Betty Page.
She'll give you your special tea and send you down the stairs here to me. the Broiler Room Studios at Griffin Heart Studios. Broiler Room at Griffin Heart Studios. Yeah, that's right. That's what I said.
For the really big old time.
Okay, just hold on. For the really big old time Radio Madison Show. Three Chords and the Truth, starring Molly Griffin. And her old dog, Blue.
And the Reverend
Blue Duke.
And the Reverend Dr. Georgie, too, coming to you live from Station GHRT in the virtual haystack in your mind, where the show always starts in 5 minutes. And we don't spin the tunes on the turntable, we spin them on our souls. So kick back, chill out, and relax to the mellow sounds of the singing DJ.
Oh, spin them on our soul. Spin them on our soul. Scatman Brothers. Old buddy of mine is dead now. They killed him on that movie.
The Shining.
Yep.
Yep.
Jack Nicholson killed him.
Yep.
He ate him.
That's not what happened.
Martha, I'm home. Hey, I'm home.
Say Martha. You haven't seen this movie.
Red Rum.
Remember when you got me to watch that?
I forced myself to watch it. It was a little boring, but now it's become like the top scary movie.
And then remember when you told a 7-year-old girl that she, no, 5, that she really liked this movie.
and mentally warped her head, for you know, traumatized.
Pretty much. You wonder why I'm afraid of everything.
Well, we all need a little PTSD. If we don't have any PTSD and we get some, we're like so shocked. We're like,
I think you were probably like, well, there's a kid in it.
Everybody needs a little PTSD.
And it's not that scary.
Perfect trauma.
you had to take
situated diagonally.
I remember we had to.
You get that? The perfect trauma situated diagonally.
The movie ended and I was just, you turned around and I was just like this. And then you took me out to McDonald's and we watched Disney sing-alongs.
Well, I thought you were going to say, I turned around and went, what the hell is wrong with you? That's what my old man would have said.
That's actually quite a fond memory because we went and got McDonald's and watched Disney movies.
Yeah, okay. Whatever. What about loss, Mom?
Childhood trauma.
I think loss is something that is relevant to everybody. Yeah. Do you understand that life can be categorized into two things? Loss and evolution.
Yeah.
You know, because you try to evolve and you lose. No.
You
loss,
gain a lot of
how
things,
do you
too.
Not? The essence of life is loss.
Yeah.
But your kids grow up, your dog dies, you die, your mom and dad die, everybody dies. It's just a loss. Every year the trees
maybe
lose.
If you're only thinking about yourself.
What?
Well, you're going down, but you are living on in your kids and they are growing up and gaining and having kids and then the circle goes on.
That's evolution. See, loss and evolution. That's what I said. But what I'm saying here is we should address loss. I don't know how. I hate it. No, I've sort of got better at it.
Mm-hmm.
I've got a little better at it. The thing is I don't look at it now as a stranger.
Mm-hmm.
I look at it as something, you know, I'm getting systems for.
Right.
You know, it doesn't take all the grief away, but you know, you get better at self-cognitive therapy, which I also like to call giving yourself a talking to.
Mm. Yeah.
And covering every detail that you can that would help you get through the bad feelings of loss. You may like them because you're sort of melancholic anyways, but me, I'm what the Buddhist people call, and I think it's because I've been tortured so much,
uh-huh.
I'm what they call the laughing man.
Yeah.
So when I get melancholia for any reason, uh-huh. It's shocking.
Yeah.
And I want
to... You don't know how to handle
it. I want to get back to the laughing man as quick as I can, right? Now, what was I talking about? Loss and grief.
Yeah.
Yeah, so you can do things like psychologists and shit will tell you to make a contract. Okay, give yourself a couple of weeks or whatever, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
But, you know, basically it's a give yourself a talking to.
Mm-hmm.
and then do everything you can. And I mean, be the more detailed and conscientious you are about all this, the better it'll be. Mm-hmm. Do all you can, and then go to the Serenity Prayer. Mm-hmm. I've done every damn thing I can. Yeah. Now let me on. And you know what trumps all of that stuff for loss?
What?
Country music. What one?
How about the one about loss? That is, you know the crowd was very small.
You bet. For a country music show. But it thanked the curtain call, just like it was years ago. Then the lady grabbed his arm as he staggered down the aisle, and with all his country charm, he addressed her with a smile. Hey, would you catch a falling star before it crashes to the ground? Hey, don't you know how people are? Nobody loves you when you're down. Hey, pick me up and take me home, and I can bring my old guitar. We'll play some golden oldie songs. Catch a falling star.
Play some golden oldie songs. We can catch a falling star.
I had a silver-plated bus
and a million country fans.
Now there's just a few of us
on my own band.
Holly drives a little van. They were beating down my door.
The lovely ladies left and right. Now I'm on the hardwood floor, wondering where I'll spend the night.
Hey, would you catch a falling star before it crashes to the ground? Hey, don't you know how people are?
John Anderson.
Yeah.
Nobody loves you when you're down.
Hey, pick me up and take me home. I can bring my old guitar. We'll play some golden country song. You could catch a falling star.
Some golden country song. You can catch a falling star.
I'm a member of a country club. Hey, country music is what I love. I drive a little old pickup truck. I do my drinking from a Dixie cup. Hey, I'm a bona fide dancing fool. I shoot a mighty mean game of pool at any honky-tonk or roadside pub. I'm a member of the country club.
Take me back into the other one.
You can catch a falling star.
Hey, would you catch a falling star before it crashes to the ground? Hey, don't you know how people are? Nobody loves you when you're down. Hey, pick me up and take me home. I can bring my old guitar. We'll play some golden country song. You can catch a falling star. We'll play some golden country song. You can catch a falling star. We'll play some golden country song. You could catch a falling star. I'm no racist, so if anybody's thinking that anything I said was racist. You know what racism means? It means when you have antagonism towards a person because of the race that they belong to.
Yeah.
Well, that's ridiculous.
Yes.
I'm sure it's true
yeah.
in cases,
yeah.
but as far as me, that's ridiculous.
Well, it's just ridiculous.
Bloody ridiculous.
Just bloody ridiculous.
Loss and grief, yep. Why is the Uncle Boy? Hey, you want to talk, right after loss and grief, we can talk about the Uncle Boy, because I think I discovered something.
What?
Like, you know what the Uncle Boy is, right?
I do,
it's when
but
something
everyone else
so
doesn't.
Bad, Uncle Boyd's son got lost
mm-hmm.
in the big bush up in British Columbia there,
mm-hmm.
with the grizzly country.
Mm-hmm.
And they sent word down that he was lost in the bush. I know I was with him.
Mm-hmm.
We're hunting. Only thing I ever killed was one duck.
And Uncle Boyd.
It was terrible. I couldn't stand it.
Uncle Boyd. Back to Uncle Boyd. Son got lost in the woods. Sent word.
Yep. And he just went into his wife and he went, he's gone. He's lost in the woods up in British Columbia. All night it's snowing. He's lost. It might not have been exactly like that, but he is my uncle, so he has my DNA. But
yeah.
It was essentially that.
Yeah.
He had lost it.
Yeah.
Yeah. And you know what? What I discovered the other day? Your brain does that automatically.
Mm-hmm.
I've had things happen to me so bad
mm-hmm.
that I went into the Uncle Boyd for years.
Yeah.
It comes from your brain. Your brain does it to save your ass.
Yeah. Shut. It like shuts down.
It's
until the shock isn't
yes,
so...
Yes, it's taking care of business.
Yeah, it shuts that down so that your brain can start to take it in.
You want
to
know more about the brain? Just go on down to Patreon. Okay. And that kind of ties into this, too, because
mm-hmm.
I started thinking in my life. I really blew it because I didn't know myself.
Mm-hmm.
When I got... Like, I went far away from home, alone.
Mm-hmm.
See, I would have known. Now I would know. I'm not going far away from home alone. I'll feel the shit.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
But I didn't know that. You read the books and, you know, the starving
mm-hmm.
artists and
mm-hmm.
poets.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, yeah, it's going to be wonderful.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We got time for one more song, Dad. You want to sing one more song? You want to sing a good one? Dad?
Sure. What do you got?
How about it?
That relates to that, because this is the game of all games within the show of all shows. She's about to pick a song that relates exactly to everything I've said.
I Can't Stop Loving You.
We didn't already sing that, right?
Nope.
I can't stop loving you. I said I made up my mind. To live in memory of the lonesome kind. I can't stop wanting you, or it's just useless to say. So I'll just live my life. Dreams of yesterday.
Dreams of yesterday.
Those happy hours.
Those happy hours
that we once knew.
That we once knew.
So long ago.
So long ago.
Still make me blue.
Still make me blue.
Oh, they say the time.
They say the time.
They heal the broken heart.
Heals a broken heart.
Yeah, but the time has stood since we've been apart, and I can't stop loving you. I said I made up my mind to live in memory of the lonesome kind. And I can't stop wanting you, oh, it's just useless to say. So I'll just live my life in dreams of yesterday. So I'll just live my life in dreams of yesterday.
gonna live my life. Dreams of yesterday. Dreams of yesterday. I don't really know how to end that song because I always come into the other song.
I thought you were gonna.
Oh, you thought I was gonna? We already sang it.
Yeah, it's done. Well, we did not. Did oh, we did.
We did. That's why I didn't sing it. You go ahead. Now listen. I got one more thing to say.
Should I go get the dog while you say it?
No. You and me, yeah, maybe. I don't know. You and me are members of a species, 8 billion now. Now, if I ask the question, this is where I need you. What are you doing?
I don't know.
You don't know, do you? The 8 billion people, they'll say, you know, I'm taking care of my kids and making money. But I'm asking it in a bigger way.
I am evolving.
What are y'all doing? What are y'all doing? Because I found out the impetus of the brain. And you know what y'all doing? Y'all doing the same as all living things. Mm. You're all trying to evolve.
Mm.
Go on down to Patreon. Okay. This is a little mental health song. You can change. You can change your mind. It might feel strange, but you can change your mind. Just flip the whole thing over and put it on the other side. Like a record. Oh, you can write yourself a letter telling you just how bad it's been. And you could send it off to someone who might care about the shape you're in. Or you could change. You could just change your mind. Oh, how much is that doggy in a window? You know the one with the waggly tail.
Oh,
the waggly tail. I say, how much is that doggy in a window? Oh, I do hope that doggies for sale.
Now I don't want a rabbit or a kitty.
Meow, meow.
I don't want a parrot that talks.
You talking to me? You talking to me?
I don't want a bowl of little fishes.
I don't want no blowfishes.
No, you can't take a goldfish for a walk.
I took a goldfish for a walk in a bag. I said, how much
is that doggy in a window?
You know the one with the waggly tail. Oh, the waggly tail.
I said,
how much is that doggy in the window? Oh, I do hope that doggy's the same.
Because if she is, we're going to go get Roger Miller.
We're
going to
go
walking
in the sunshine, sing a little sunshine song. Bobby, oh, Bobby, oh, boy, you got to put a smile upon your face as if there's nothing wrong. Bobby, oh, boy, you got to think about a good time. Hell, a long time ago. Think about forgetting about your worries, ain't your woes. Walking in the sunshine, singing a sunshine song. Are you all go walking in the sunshine, singing a little sunshine song? Hey, I forgot to say that Don Gibson was my girlfriend's uncle, and he wrote that I Can't Stop Loving You. And he made a pew box on it, and then Ray Charles took it and made a fortune. And if any of you care a damn thing about the brain crap, you go on down to Patreon, Griffinhardt at Patreon there. Keep the cards and letters coming in. We'll see you in the funny papers, and have yourselves a, hey, wait a minute, have yourselves a Corona reprieve. Corona reprieve, Corona reprieve, have yourself Corona reprieve, Corona reprieve. And Dolce Vito's.